I shouldn't be that much judgmental. I was a teenager when I got married. I was 19. I was very mature, which is very easy to believe because this is mature me. And I said fall breeze of feces 5 minutes ago. So I used to think it was hilarious to write on my wife's grocery list butt cream. Because that was this hilarious imaginary thing I made up when I was 19. And now I'm in my 30s and I still write butt cream, but not ironically. I write butt cream and then parentheses, I put extra strength. But I got married young because I fell for a girl way out of my league. And I don't mean that in like an overly complimentary way. Like when people see us together, they're like, huh. Oh, I bet he's funny. I bet. There's some personality there. We were getting jaded though, me and my wife. Not towards each other, just towards marriage in general. I know we're getting jaded because the last wedding we went to, we were giggling during the vows. We couldn't take it seriously, you know? Because that doesn't mean anything. That means nothing. Absolutely nothing. It means nothing at all. That is not a marriage. That is a wedding. Those are different things. A marriage is tomorrow when they get to the airport and she goes, I forgot my passport. Now you're married. That's the ceremony right there. Till death do us part. Tomorrow, I'm going to Mexico alone. You had one job. One job! We're starting to get real honest in marriage, though. It's starting to hit, like, you know, I asked my wife if she was attracted to one of my friends, and this went poorly. But not in the way I anticipated it going poorly. Actually, I was like, hey, my friend there, are you attracted to him? And she goes, you know, I'm not really attracted to guys based on the way they look. I was like, that is the meanest thing. That hurts so bad. I'd rather you tell me you fantasize about him every day. That is, you just undid me on like a molecular level. Don't get me wrong, I was always confused, but I thought you were into this, you know? I thought this was your thing. But I know, I'm very specific. I'm very niche, but I thought this is what you wanted. I thought you were like, you know what I want out of a guy is I want a guy who like looks like he reads comic books and is hard to push over. That's what I want. I want him sturdy and nerdy. That's how I want him. I know it's, you know, we're getting jaded, but we're also like, I think we have a good, healthy, realistic, you know, idea of what marriage is. Like, people ask for advice a lot, and that's a compliment. They go, oh, how do I know who's the one? How do I know? Go, listen, if you really want to know who you're supposed to spend the rest of your life with, ignore everything positive about them. That does not help you. Look at the most annoying thing about a person. The thing that drives everybody else in their life crazy. And if you can stand that thing, then that's your soulmate. That's how you know. Because you have to adore somebody and endure them. You need both of those things. And that should be the stuff on dating apps. It shouldn't be like, I like to kayak. It should be like, I grind my teeth at night, FYI. Oh, you have a sleep apnea machine? Perfect, perfect. That'll drown that out nicely. There are tests along the way. Like if you're in a relationship with somebody right now and they say espresso, and you don't want to murder them, then marry them right then and there. I do. There is no X in that word. You are uncultured and illiterate. You understand me? That's how I know me and my wife are each other. We can stand each other's things. My wife can't say the word salsa correctly. She says salsa. Like, may I have some chips and salsa? You feel that tension right there? I've said it twice. You all hate her already. That's actually a big part of it. People say, oh, like, you need to love the same things. No, you need to hate the same things. Hate is so much more powerful than love. It's not even close. It's not even close. Let your love grow through bitterness and spite. Honestly. Me and my wife have a couple friends in our life that everything they do, we hate. And that's why they're in our lives. They are the single most important thing in our relationship because they do something annoying and then we get together and talk crap about them and then our love blossoms. That's what they're they're there for. They're the young couple that always tries to, like, flex or, like, get on our level or, like, try and impress us. You know, Dustin, every night we still fall asleep together cuddling. I'm not impressed by that. You know why you cuddle early on in a relationship? Because you're still afraid they're gonna leave. That's why. You're not cuddling, you're holding on. That's not romance, that's a hostage situation. They'd leave if they could. You know what a happy couple looks like in bed? Could you be further away? Further away, I don't want to feel you. Further away. I don't want to know you're here. Like a happy couple invented the California king because the king bed didn't suffice. Further away. Share blankets? No, I don't want to share blankets with you. I got my own farts to deal with over here. I've spent the last half an hour carefully cocooning myself into a burrito of stench so they don't leak out to your side because I love you. Folks, thank you so much for watching. Please go download the Drybar app, and when you do, use promo code Dustin Nickerson.